So this is to show the anatomical position of the spleen. Sometimes the spleen, when it is detached from the body, it is confusing. So in order to show the relations of a detached spleen, hold the spleen so that the diaphragmatic smooth surface of the spleen is against the palm of your left hand, and hold it so that the thumb is opposite the notch of the spleen. The notch of the spleen is related to the superior border of the spleen. It is a reminder of its mineralogical origin, because the spleen develops from multiple splenic nodules, and then they fuse together. And so if you put the thumb against the notch of the spleen, then your little finger will be against the this surface of the spleen that is related to the colon. And this impression on the visceral surface of the spleen is related to the stomach. It is located anteriorly and posteriorly here. This impression will be the impression of the left kidney. The other structure that is related to the spleen is at the hilum of the spleen. This is the region of the hilum where the splenic artery and splenic vein are located, in addition to the tail of the pancreas. So here you can see the spleen. That is the notch of the spleen. And anteriorly, this is the stomach. I will remove the stomach, and this is the impression of the stomach on the visceral surface of the spleen. You can see the tail of the pancreas related to the hilum of the spleen. And posteriorly, there is the kidney. Here, this is the left colic flexure or the splenic flexure. I will remove the colon now. And you can see the relation of the kidney here. And this is the impression for the colon. Here again, I will show you the relations of the spleen on this detached spleen from the cadaver. So I'm holding it with my left hand. The diaphragmatic surface is opposite my palm. The thumb is against the notch of the spleen. And this surface that is very close to the thumb, an impression, is the relation of, or is the stomach impression, gastric impression. And opposite my little finger is the colonic impression. And behind, this is the renal impression. Actually, when the spleen enlarges, it has to be enlarged at least three times its normal size so that it will be palpable beneath the costal margin. And when the spleen enlarges, the superior border of the spleen will come like this, antero-inferiorly, and will come to be anterior, where you can feel the notch of the spleen, which is characteristic of a mass in the abdomen. So the spleen has a superior border, it has an inferior border, it has an anterior pole, anterior end, which is wide, and it has a posterior pole here, which is narrow. And this is the hilum of the spleen, where you can see the splenic vein and the splenic artery. And sometimes you can see the tail of the pancreas. It is not shown here because it has been detached while removing the spleen from the cadaver.